Hello, and welcome to Monthly Mailbag, where we answer your science questions. Today's question comes from a 10-year-old RI member, and he writes, if everything in the universe moved at the speed of light, would time exist? You've probably heard that as objects speed up, time slows down for them. And then maybe it occurred to you that if something was traveling at the speed of light, time might stop for that object. And time stopping is akin to it not even existing. So the natural extension is, if everything were traveling at the speed of light, surely all time would stop, meaning that time would cease to exist. There are a few assumptions in there, though. So let's break them down in order to understand one of the 20th century's greatest discoveries, special relativity. One of Einstein's big contributions to science is the notion that time isn't constant for everyone. In a weird way, this is the result of the observation that light always travels at 300 million meters per second in a vacuum, no matter which direction it's moving. To understand why, imagine a very simple time-telling device, a laser and a mirror, oriented vertically up and down. If you know how far away the laser is from the mirror, and the speed of light is constant, then it's really easy to find out how long it takes for light to bounce from the laser to the mirror back to the laser. If the clock starts moving sideways, the laser light has to trace a diagonal path, which is much longer than the vertical path that it had to take before. But since the speed of light can't change, and the distance between the laser and the mirror hasn't changed, the only thing that can change is the time. Time ran slow for that moving clock. In fact, we now know that time runs slow for anything that moves. But if you were moving at the same speed as that clock, it would seem like it was just acting normally. This is very similar to if you drop a ball in a moving plane or car. The ball will drop straight down, but if you trace the path from outside that moving vehicle, it'll go sideways and down. So time definitely slows down for moving objects. But can you get objects to move at the speed of light? To answer this question, we need to think about another one of Einstein's big discoveries, that mass and energy aren't just related, they're equivalent. This is the famous equation E equals mc squared. And as you add energy to an object by speeding it up, you're also adding mass. Thinking back to Newton, we know that more massive objects are harder to accelerate. They take more force. This is F equals ma. Usually, the tiny increase in mass from additional speed is negligible. But when we're talking about speeds close to the speed of light, known in the physics biz as relativistic, it becomes a real factor. Particle accelerators like the Large Hadron Collider just wouldn't work without taking this increase in mass into consideration. The amount of energy it takes to speed something with mass up to the speed of light is infinite. And as we know, there's no such thing as infinite energy, so it's not just hard, it's impossible. The faster an object is moving, the more energy it takes to increase its speed. The only things that can travel at the speed of light are massless particles, photons, of light. But let's imagine that it is possible to get the universe moving at the speed of light. Since we know that time appears to slow down as objects approach the speed of light, would it stop altogether when the object reaches 300 million meters per second? Yes. The equation for time slowing down with speed, also known as time dilation, looks like this. The time for the moving clock is equal to the time for the stationary clock divided by the square root of 1 minus the speed squared divided by the speed of light squared, c squared. As the speed gets closer to the speed of light, v squared, the speed squared, over c squared gets closer to 1, which means that whole bottom bit of the equation gets closer to 0, which means that whole side of the equation goes to infinity. So any given amount of time for the moving clock, any moment, takes literally forever for the stationary clock. If you're the stationary clock, it will appear as if that moving clock has stopped. But when time stops, does it cease to exist? This is a really tricky question because it becomes hard to remember that the moving clock has only appeared to stop from the perspective of the stationary one. If you were the moving one, your clock would be running normally, and it'd be the stationary one that would appear to have stopped. Time still exists, it just looks different depending on how fast you're moving relative to something else. It's helpful in this instance to think of time as just a fourth dimension, much like the other three, up and down, in and out, side to side. This was yet another one of Einstein's great contributions to science, treating time as just a part of the universe's coordinate system, space-time. Just because you're not moving in it, doesn't mean that it doesn't exist. And this brings us to the underlying problem with this plan to end time. If everything was going the same constant speed in the same direction, we wouldn't know. It'd be impossible to tell. Light would still travel at the speed of light, but no faster, like it always does. And things would fall straight down like they normally do when you drop them, and life would continue. In fact, we might already be doing this. Relativistic effects like time dilation and length contraction, which we didn't get into but is really weird, are only apparent when there's relative motion. The clue is in the name, special relativity. So let's revisit the question. If everything in the universe moved at the speed of light, would time exist? Time does slow down for moving objects, but you can't get objects with mass to go the speed of light. And while time might stop for an object moving at the speed of light, that doesn't mean that time stops altogether. And crucially, if everything was going the same speed, then it would be like nothing was moving at all. So luckily for us, time will keep on going. Hi guys, me again. You may remember me from such things as the video that you just watched, but I'm here to tell you that next month we're making a Christmas-themed episode, which means we need your Christmas-themed questions, like what's the scientifically best way to wrap a present, or does Santa need time travel to go all the way around the world in one night? Send them in or comment below, and we'll get to them next month.